Thanks for helping me, Dorothy. I really appreciate it.
It's no problem, Ansel. Anything for a friend.
Yeah, I don't think I would have been able to do it if I didn't have you. Thank you. I truly appreciate it. So did you hear about Wells coming?
No.
I don't really know these people, but there's this guy named Steven Spielberg, John Wayne, Bobby Jr., Charlie, and Warren Beatty.
That's pretty interesting. Can't wait to meet them.
Me neither.
Excuse me, guys. Is it where the dinner party is?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm Robert Downey Jr.
Oh, hello. I'm Ansel.
Hello, I'm Dorothy.
Yeah, nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you too. What do you do, Robert?
I'm actually nice to meet you.
Oh. Okay, that's crazy.
Thank you very much. How did that happen? You guys need to fix it so good. I'm gonna be there in a couple hours. Who else is coming?
Charles Schultz, Warren Beatty, Steven Spielberg, and a guy named John Wayne?
Speak of the devil!
Oh, are you John Wayne?
John Wayne, yep.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too, John.
Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Robert Downey Jr.
My name's Adam.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
My favorite picture is Be My Great
Why? I like that picture because it was the one that started my career.
Really?
Yeah. It's also been the most inspiration to people.
Mm-hmm. I'm having some great movies.
You took a picture of Star Wars.
Highest paid actor in Hollywood industry.
That's pretty insane.
Yeah, that is pretty insane. So what kind of movies you made?
It's inspired people to make great things. And there are no starving children in it.
So how did you start?
So it's a picture of a mountain, and there's just a river just slithering through like a snake.
That sounds like it would be pretty to see in life.
Yeah, it was.
This one guy noticed me, and he's like, "Hey, I'm going to put you in a role." And he put me in a role.
Okay.
Yeah.
So mine was, I did my first movie as a debut actor while I was age 5. Mm-hmm. And it was pretty okay at that time. Mm-hmm. After that, my dad introduced me to the drugs, and you know what happened.
Your picture is saved in my camera now.
I pretty had time at that point at the beginning of the career. Now I'm really good. I'm getting paid really well. And that's it, man. My story is still gonna go.
Hey guys!
What's up?
Oh, this is the dinner party, right?
Yeah.
My name is Steven Spielberg, and you must be Ansel Adams.
Yeah, I take pictures.
Cool.
Nice to meet you, my name's Warren.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you too,
John Wayne.
Oh, okay, yes, the Duke himself.
Robert Downey Jr., man.
Nice to meet you.
Robert! I'm actually a huge fan.
Really?
Yeah.
What's your name, though?
My name's Warren. Thank you.
So, here we are at Yosemite. Pretty beautiful.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so I was thinking maybe shooting a movie here sometime. Do you have any good location ideas?
Well, there's this waterfall over there, and it's really, really pretty how the water glistens in the sun.
I think I've been to the waterfall.
Really? Is it pretty?
Yeah, it is pretty, man.
Yeah. Cool.
The nature is there so beautiful.
Yeah, it might be a good location for the upcoming movie.
I've actually never been to Yosemite.
Really? Yeah. This is one of my first times. This is my absolute first time. But yeah.
Yeah, I never went to the park, but I went to the waterfall over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've been to Yosemite before. I've even taken pictures of it.
I shot some westerns here.
Really? In Yosemite?
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Just a couple scenes. That's pretty fascinating, actually. Mm-hmm.
Very interesting.
How's your life?
You know, it's pretty good. Making movies. You know, I've got some new movies coming. Like Ready Player One is supposed to be pretty big, and also The Post. Some of the new movies that should go pretty well.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
What kind of movie you made? Like.
Well, hold on. Before we get to that.
May I?
Yeah, sure, Ansel. What's a movie? A movie is, well, you are a photographer. And basically a movie is a bunch of pictures right next to each other, all played in a line, basically. And when you play them really fast, that's how you get a movie.
Oh, that's pretty interesting.
Yeah, and when you make a movie, certain things matter. You know, same as filmmaking, or maybe photography. Warren also knows about this.
Yes, I do. I'm also an actor, and I also create films. Movies.
Well, I never had movies when I was a kid, but I think the concept is good.
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
Yeah, sounds like it. I just take pictures of trees.
Trees are cool. I'm gonna make a tree documentary pretty soon.
That's pretty
maybe
cool.
Robert could be a main character.
Yeah, I can, man.
Aren't we missing somebody?
Charles Schultz. He should be getting here pretty soon, I believe.
Might be running late.
Yeah.
You know, that guy sometimes can be like that.
Speaking of peanuts.
I don't reckon anybody here said anything about peanuts.
Oh.
You must be Charles Schultz. My name's Ansel.
Nice
I take
to
pictures.
Meet you. Comic strip designer.
That's cool.
Pretty cool, man.
Yep.
Nice to meet you, John Wayne.
Nice
to meet you,
Charles.
Attention. In case any of you were wondering why you were here, I thought I'd throw a celebration dinner party to celebrate how diverse art is. But before we get into that, let's eat.
Yeah. So I brought this chicken pot pie.
Ooh. I have an apple.
That's a tortilla. This is actually chicken pot pie, so
I brought a burrito.
You must like burritos a lot.
Yeah.
I brought my favorite salami sandwich.
My peanut butter sandwich.
So I got just some water to drink.
Me too.
Water.
I got something better than water. And you're in the water anyway.
Okay, now.
Bacon
no.
Hot chocolate.
Ew.
That sounds gross.
I don't want any bacon hot chocolate. No, thank you.
Yeah, that sounds disgusting.
Sounds like somebody busted.
Sick.
More for me.
Does that have your name on it?
So I'd like to start off in this beautiful night in Yosemite talking about filmmaking.
What about it?
Well, you know, it's a good type of art. You know, in my opinion, art it really is about, you know, sharing your ideas, and one of the best ways to do that is, you know, through visual. You know, a lot of people learn better visually than, you know, like reading or
same with actually.
Yeah. And you know, filmmakers use actors, of course, like Mr. Downey and Wayne. You know.
Yeah.
Actors, you know, they use acting as their form of art. They share their ideas and express themselves, which is really beautiful if you think about it.
Yeah.
It truly
yeah.
is.
I never thought about it that way.
Yeah.
It's almost as good as just regular art.
Yeah, you know, technology has made a lot of, has allowed a lot of advancements today in the modern world that really, it's really changed the world. You know, like people really look up to movies and they, it's a giant part of pop culture and people just see movies as a really important part of their lives and people pay a lot of money to see movies. It's really one of the biggest businesses currently.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Wayne, why are you putting mild sauce on your sandwich?
I didn't know what this sauce was, so I decided to try it.
Do you like it? Oh. Okay, Mr. Wayne.
It's pretty good.
Back to talking about filmmaking.
Okay.
Yeah, so, Warren, your thoughts?
No. I really like filmmaking. I think it's a cool art.
Anything else?
You've been doing this for over 30
years. You've been doing this for a while. You should be able to say more.
I don't know, man. I just really like it.
Excuse me while I use the globe sword.
Okay. Enjoy your time.
Good luck.
Anyways, back on topic. Charles, You don't know much about the current technology, you know. You draw, you know, good old pen and paper. You're not into this whole lens and stuff. What are your thoughts on filmmaking?
My thoughts on filmmaking is that it's incredible how amazing it's gotten, because it just shows that all it just shows the kids what it really is. They can imagine. They don't now the days you can't imagine stuff. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, you had to imagine what they were doing.
Very true. Very true. This is a really good chicken pot pie.
It's not chicken pot pie.
Yeah, it is. You enjoying your burrito?
Mm-hmm. Back in my day, we called that a tortilla.
Okay, Ansel. So, filmmaking and photography, you know, they have their similarities.
Definitely do.
Yeah, Dorothy would know, because she's a photographer. Sure, you Ansel.
I love making a statement with my photos. Just really helps people a lot. Yeah. Especially back in my time.
Yeah, you like
oh,
taking pictures
John's
of
back.
Starving people.
Welcome
that's
back.
Offensive.
Well, it's true.
Did you enjoy your sandwich?
At least I didn't take pictures of dead
trees. Okay, guys. Guys, calm down. John Wayne has arrived, and we were just talking about how filmmaking and photography are kind of similar. So, what are your thoughts on that?
I'm not a filmmaker or a photographer. I just do what the filmmaker tells me to. So. I mean,
well, the filmmaker is telling you to give your thoughts, so.
filmmaker is the most important role because they pretty much write the movie, right? And then
nope.
They.
We'll move on to Robert. Did you share? What are your thoughts?
No. I think that we both are kind of same. In art, you can express your feelings by drawing. And photograph, you can take the nature pictures and to show the other people that never been there or never realized that they're the thing on the earth. Acting is pretty much art too. Like, you can express your feelings by your expressions. And how you feel about your life. That's what I think.
Okay, well, moving on. I'd like to hear about some of your photos. Dorothy, I don't really know much about them. Kind of meeting you for the first time.
That's peanut butter in my mouth, hold on.
There's
peanut butter in my mouth. Okay. Back in my time, I usually took photos that would help inspire people. Like, I really wanted to take photos that showed people what was going on during the times.
Mm. When was your time?
During the Great Depression.
Oh, the Great Depression, of course.
Yeah.
And what was life back,
probably
like
laughs
back then?
As soon as she says depression, she giggles. The Great Depression. Oh. Do you guys have any family?
I do. Two kids and one wife.
Yeah, I got some kids. They're pretty cool. Funny story, actually, I am married to the female lead in the movie Temple of Doom, which is a movie I helped work on, so that's pretty cool.
Hey, me too. I got remarried too.
Oh, I never said I was remarried.
You said it.
No, I said I married her. I never said I was remarried.
Well, I've been remarried.
Oh, that's
Well,
nice.
I got remarried too.
It was actually my family that started a foundation after I died.
Really?
To prevent cancer, yeah.
Oh, really?
Wow. Do you have any family, Warren?
Yes, actually. I have one wife and two kids.
Do we have to keep saying one wife? Like,
that was my already said it.
Like, I'm pretty sure we all have one wife, unless you guys are...
My five wives.
Unless you guys got something
I'm
to say.
I'm a pimp. I'm a pimp.
Charles? No. I hear you have some children.
Yes, I have five children. I divorced my first wife and got married to my beautiful, stunning wife. She's about 86 right now.
Wow!
That's pretty cool.
Is she one handsome young lady?
Yeah.
I have a mom and a dad.
I'm pretty sure we all do, unless they're dead, like mine.
Like mine.
My mom actually helped me with art.
Well, that sucks for you.
My
it sucks for you that instead of art.
family. Hoping maybe we could talk about, you know, our jobs. Like, we all know, like, I'm a filmmaker, you're a photographer, but talk about, like, why we enjoy our job so much. Like, why did I choose filmmaking instead of, say, art, you know?
I just wanted to be a photographer.
Excuse me, guys, I got a phone call.
You got another phone call?
Yeah, man.
All right.
My parents really inspired me to become a photographer.
Photographer?
I've never heard that word in my life.
My parents really inspired me to become a photographer because I was just inspired by all the creative thinking around when I was younger.
Ansel, could you please calm down? Ansel, please calm down. Anyway,
I used to watch a lot of movies, and that's what got me inspired to do filmmaking.
Nice.
And I've actually met a lot of famous people over my time.
Nice.
Such as Marilyn Monroe.
Didn't you kill her?
No, that's a conspiracy theory.
You didn't kill Marilyn Monroe.
So, right, you hit her body in the creek and then killed her and then found her.
Sorry, guys. No.
Oh,
isn't it too hot on here?
What?
Isn't it too hot? Or is it just me hot?
No, it's actually pretty chilly in my opinion.
I
think it's too
hot.
I'm
freeze.
Or it's just me hot.
John Wayne's a little bit weird.
So
yeah,
why do you like being a comic strip creator?
Because my mom has always helped me get into art, which has always strived my way to get under the top and build it. And I hope I make little children feel my pain when I was younger.
Cool. So, Robert and John, the actors in the room, why did you guys choose acting?
Because my dad was an actor and my mom was an actor too. And I was interested in drama in the beginning when I was a child. Then my dad put me in the acting field.
Oh, nice. John?
Actually, after football, because I got a really bad surf accident, hurt my shoulder. I worked at a stage. I helped set it up, the stage. And this one guy saw me and was like, hey, you want to be in a role? And I said, yeah. And so that really started everything off, and that's why I really like it.
Nice.
My
Hot
Pocket.
Yeah, so I decided to be a filmmaker. I was inspired when I was a kid by some specific movies. You know, they really wanted me to, made me want to get into,
what kind of,
you know,
movies?
The filmmaking.
Did you both enjoy your food?
Oh, yeah, my chicken pot pie was really good.
Yeah, I enjoyed my food. My peanut butter sandwich is pretty good. I love peanut butter.
That apple was peanut butter.
My burrito was good.
I like peanut butter.
Yeah, you should like peanuts. You should like peanuts since you do have an entire comic strip named Peanuts.
Now that is a good joke.
Yeah,
good pun there.
So, Warren,
I know what that is.
Yes.
You know, kind of have a thing going between us. You know, we're always arguing about who's a better filmmaker. I think this is the perfect opportunity to kind of settle it once and for all with all these really smart people here to settle it with us.
At a dinner party.
Yeah, at a dinner party. We're going to see who is the better filmmaker. So, one of the reasons I think as to why I'm definitely a better filmmaker, you know, I have a lot more money than you. You know, I've made a lot more money off of my films.
You know, money is not everything, okay?
Yeah. He's right.
How much money you have?
It's about inspiring people.
Well, what kind of
money? How much money do you have?
I have millions of dollars.
How many?
I don't know. It's too
How many you
count.
Got?
There's too many to count.
How many
count
movies
money?
Have you
he
made?
He says there's too many to count. Well, I'm actually going to be honest. I have $70 million.
Yeah, I'm rich than you, man. I got
$260
million. Dollars.
I'm wow. rich than you.
I have made a lot of really good movies. You know, my movies have been well received. You know, I've made a lot of movies and I still have a good career. You know, like, I've made over 50 movies. How many movies have you made?
Oh my god, okay, that doesn't even matter. I am well respected in Hollywood.
Yeah, well, I'm probably more respected than you.
Doubt it.
Hey guys.
Yeah?
Smile!
Cheers!
Wow, that was great.
Best episode.
I also got Blink.
We both suck. Raise your hand if you think we both suck. Wow! It has been settled, ladies and gentlemen. Woo!
What about you guys? Education?
Education? Yeah, it's pretty good. I'm done with school currently. I'm not going to school. But I actually dropped out of college.
Me? I was dropped out from high school.
Wow.
I'm sad to say, but I was only in
I was only in
homeschool because nobody liked me at real school.
Wow.
That's sad. That's bad.
What about you, Charles?
I failed all through high school, 8th and 9th grade. And after that, I went to the Army, had my time there, got a free scholarship to college, got my tuition and everything paid off. Went there, and I started getting to the art program after my mom convinced me to actually do it. And then after that, my career just took off.
Wow. I'm
proud of you, man.
To be honest, I also failed through most of my schooling.
We all are same.
After that, I went to the University of Columbia to study photography.
Wow,
hold on, so you failed through high school, but you went to the University of Columbia?
Well, I had to fix my act towards the end.
Yeah, so you're talking about going to the Army. I've had a little bit of experience in the Army.
So
I haven't gone to the Army myself. I haven't gone to the Army myself, but I was a Boy Scout, so I've been asked for the
I didn't go to the Army, but pretty similar.
Yeah, everybody's going to say anything.
That's what
did you want
go.
To say something, John?
Yeah, I actually...
What? John, do you have something to say?
Yes, I do.
Please say it.
I went through high school, played football, and got a full ride to college. And then in college, I got into surf accident, you know, shoulder. And they took away my scholarship. And that's why you suck. That's why I'm in a lot of movies. Okay. I'm actually a $15 million
$15 million.
$15 million. Ever heard of inflation?
No.
So, Ansel and Dorothy, I heard that you guys made a business. Aperture, was it?
Yeah, we both co-founded the Aperture.
Aperture Foundation.
Oh, okay, cool.
What she said.
Yeah, I've made a couple businesses in my time, you know. Helped make Amblin Entertainment, which is what I make most of my movies under, and I also co-founded the company DreamWorks, which, you know, make the movie Shrek. You ever heard of Shrek?
Shrek?
My kids watch
no.
Shrek.
Yeah, everyone watches Shrek. It's basically known around the world right now.
Yeah, we're making another one. Shrek 3, though.
Shrek
best.
5?
Shrek 3 was the best.
Shrek 2 was the best, in my opinion.
I think you should make a Shrek TV show because when the kids watch it, it's over and they can't watch it anymore.
Robert, would you like to be a voice actor for the new Shrek TV show?
I will, if you pay me good.
Give me your best Shrek impression.
I think I could do it better.
Yeah, I think
Alright, show me your Shrek impression.
I'm an ogre!
Wow, you're hired! Oh, round of applause!
Well, I actually had a business after I died, you know, foundation, as I was talking about before, after I died, my family, John Wayne Foundation.
About preventing cancer, right?
Mm-hmm. Not preventing cancer, because you can't really prevent cancer.
You can cure cancer, though.
So it's researching cancer.
Did you just say you can cure cancer?
Yeah.
They're finding a cure for cancer.
You already find it.
I don't know.
That's not what we're here for.
They found a cure for cancer?
That's not what we're here to talk about.
Okay. So, where were you guys born? I was born in San Francisco myself. Funny fact, actually. See how my nose is so crooked, you know? Well, when I was only 4 years old, I was thrown into my garden wall by the earthquake of San Francisco in 1906.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Don't make fun of my nose.
I was born in New Jersey.
I was born in New York.
I was born in Cincinnati, Ohio.
I was born in Hollywood.
I was born in the grandest stage in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
John, where were you born?
Nowhere.
No comment.
Okay.
In a hospital.
So something I'd like to talk about before we get into the whole art thing. No, still getting to know each other. Political views, maybe?
Why do you want to talk about politics?
I don't like Trump. I'm a Democrat myself.
Hey, we are buddies.
Hey.
Guys?
Yeah?
What's a T-Rom?
Trump is the current president, but, I'm a Democrat. Apparently, Robert's a Democrat, too. I mean, that's great. Yeah.
Who else is Democrat?
Do you even know what a president is?
I'm a Republican.
Y'all liberals get away from me.
I'm sorry, guys, but I really believe right now.
Oh, okay, well, it was nice meeting you, Dorothy.
Goodbye.
Nice to meet you, Dorothy.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Dorothy.
See you next week.
Goodbye.
See you, Dorothy. Okay.
Have a great night!
So, there's enough goofing around. There's a reason why we're here. And it's to celebrate the diversity of art.
I think we do art in every different kind of ways.
Yeah.
Like, everything is art, man.
Yeah, really, if you really think about it, anything can be art.
Yeah.
Everything we do is art, and
yeah.
There's different aspects of art that all of us perform.
Yeah.
And they fit together, they really do. You know, because like, you know, actual drawn art, it inspires. Filmmaking inspires, photographs, they inspire. It's really what art is all about, it's just inspiring people.
Yeah.
And creating something cool.
Yeah, creating something really cool, nice.
Exactly. That's fun.
Yeah.
It changed from where it was from where it is now.
Yeah, and art is changing. That is something.
It's totally changing.
That
all
is
the time.
Something that you need to think about is that art will change. But, you know, art speaks to everyone through all types of eras. You know, that's why it's so beautiful.
Yeah. Okay, see you guys.
So while we're all now.
Nice meeting you guys. And thank you for inviting
me. It was nice meeting you,
nice meeting you too,
nice
Robert.
Meeting you guys.
Robert Downey.
Nice to meet you.
Mr. Robert.
Such a big fan.
Thank you, man.
Bye.
See you all, guys.
Goodbye. Group photo, you guys. Say cheese.
Oh, okay.
Peanuts.
Cheese.
Peanuts.
That was great. But, you know, me and Warren actually have to go. We have to go. We're going to do film. So, it was really nice meeting you guys, though. Nice to meet you, Charles. Ansel, it was very nice meeting you. Nice to meet you, John.
Nice to meet you, Warren.
But, yeah, we gotta go.
Bye. Goodbye.
See ya.
Bye.
I'm gonna be, plus my cancer's acting up. Goodbye.
Nice meeting you.
I guess it's just the both of us.
Yeah. So, see you later. I have to go do some stuff.
Oh, that's how it is? Okay.
For some comic strips. Thank you.
Yeah. Bye. Well, I guess I'll be
with your mood directing going on.
Speaking of peanuts,
no one said anything about peanuts.
That wasn't your line.
So, right?
Yeah, of course.
The bag's
okay.
In the way. No, I'm just going to leave it.
The bag is up. Dude, I swear.
Three.
Put it like right.
Two.
Give me
one
bear.
One.
Attention!
Okay. Just get our attention. Don't get
in my eyes. Ow!
Three! Oh, wait, I need to get my water bottle out.
This
my
man that just got lost his virginity at 76 just punched me in the nose.
My phone's gonna die, bro. Hurry up. So.
Yeah, like, have you heard of this Logan Paul guy?
Get out of my room! I'm playing Minecraft!
Okay. Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang, Gucci gang. Oh my god.
Okay,
I ran on you,
Jay. It's freaking recording!
Hey, guys!
His name's Robert.
Okay. I'm gonna just leave.
I was born in Cincinnati, Ohio. Are you kidding me, Skylar?
I was born in New Jersey.
I was okay, no, we have to restart this because of freaking
Skylar.
It's the Spanish national anthem. I'm yeah, sorry. Sure.
Oh my
Turn
God.
Your phone on ringer!
Mom's calling, I'm sorry.
Turn your phone on ringer. All the different traits, it all works together to Are you freaking- why didn't you put your phone on ringer?
Come on!
Come on,
I don't want to keep doing this!
Hey, you should put this on bloopers. Come on!
I'm out of water now.
So guys, just the guys now. That's pretty nice.
Yeah.
You guys wanna watch the game? Crack open a beer?
Yeah, man.
Stop flipping, Austin.
Why
are bottle flipping?
Get
it,
son.
It's dead.
Bye, Kylia.
2016.
Man, I'm sorry, dude, but it's a new trend.
Okay.